We are going to jot down notes or just listen to me until the end of our presentation. So our discussion for tonight, it will be animal nutrition, animal breeding, and genetics. So I'm going to highlight some important terminologies, no? Kasi nga kanina, we know na ang daming lumabas na mga macro and micro minerals sa soils. And then some of you, ano, masaya sa crop science, malungkot naman sa crop science. Masaya sa soils. Pero guys, congratulations, no? Chukaham nida. Yan, chukaham nida. Yuribon chukaham nida, because you guys did your very best to answer the questions, to answer your board examination. So, do not worry, because we still have 4 subjects to go and we can pull them up, no, para makaya pa natin 'yon. Okay, kaya babawi tayo for tomorrow's exam. Okay? So, our exam for tomorrow, it will be crop protections and animal science. We know that animal science is quite bleeding at all. Wait, ganun. It's quite bleeding, no? Pero kailangan natin 'yon. Kailangan natin mag-focus tayo sa kailangan natin mag-focus. Ayun. Kailangan po natin mag-focus kasi pag hindi po tayo mag-focus, no, parang mawawala lang din yung mga pinag-aralan natin. So Jay, kindly call your ano, kindly ano lang Nick, mention yung mga classmates mo, Jay. Ako na lang siguro. Medyo may lakas yung signal ko. Ginako ako na. Yes?
Masa?
If you have friend, tapos mga classmates ninyo nagtitake ng board exam ngayon, pasok po kayo ha. Papasukin sila. And then, actually, naka-live po ako ngayon sa YouTube. Okay, so they can access the YouTube. Where's that? Okay, if they cannot get inside the gym, they can access or they can watch on YouTube. Okay? Okay, by the way, the rationale for the animal science is already posted doon po sa ating ano, doon po sa so the rationale na folder. So kindly check it. Andun na po yung animal science and also the crop protection. Check it and double check kasi para aware po tayo. So our discussion for crop protection, it will be entomology. Kung nagtataka kayo si sir, bakit ako nakahiga? Because I don't have here extra chairs. So ayun po. Kung nagtataka kayo. So, I don't have extra chairs here. Even, ano, wala din. Basta wala akong extra chairs dito. That's the, ano, the point. Kumusta ang exam ninyo? Hopefully, ay okay lang po kayo. Hopefully, wala pong umiyak, nasaktan. Charot, nasaktan. At wala po yung ano, at sana po yung walang taong sinaktan yung sarili. Sinaktan yung sarili. Okay, so tomorrow is entomology. Then, hindi natin alam kung anong lalabas sa exam, but last year, marami pong lumabas sa weed science at saka entomology. So, crop protection para tomorrow. So, kaya, no, dapat ay ang i-focus natin ngayon is entomology since I am done with tapos na po ako sa ano sa weed science nung nakaraan. So kindly check on my YouTube channel. I have there the weed science, and do not forget also to memorize the scientific names of the top 10 world wars weeds, because that will come out sa board examination, not just only the scientific name but also the common name. Actually, I already gave it sa GC. Kindly check it. It's either on the file link or sa image. Okay, nandun lang po yan. Okay, And to all WEMSO students out there, hello po, magandang gabi. Ano nga sa'yo? Lahat po ng mga taga-WEMSO dyan, pumapasok na po yung mga students natin from WEMSOs. So, ayan po, hi! Hopefully po ay marami tayong WEMSO passers. I'm praying for that. Okay? Para naman masaya yung ating alma mater. Okay? And hoping that you already memorize the insect orders because that will really come out sa board examination. Ang insect orders po kailangan na memorize na natin, ha? Opo. So, whether it will come out sa exam or not, at least alam natin yung mga insect orders. Okay? Pag tinanong tayo, even we are not agriculturists, no? Agriculturists or not, at least alam natin magsagot. Alam natin sumagot. Okay? So, I do not need to point here all the hindi ko na kailangan talaga na discuss yung tawag dyan, yung insect orders. Kasi yun na nga, dapat kayo yun ang naka-memorize nyo na yun, i-memorize nyo na yun. Actually, meron yan sa GE. Hanapin nyo sa GE, tapos meron silang mga mouth parts behavior nila. Yun. Okay? So, check nyo na lang po. Please, yun, memorize nyo na po. Kung hindi nyo pa mo-memorize, kasi sa klase ko, in my private class, both face-to-face and online, they are memorized na po yan nila. Okay? And then, also, baka mag-discuss ako ng mga diseases ngayon. Okay? So, I'll be discussing more about diseases and also, ayan, biological control. Ay! Oh my God! Sige, sige lang. Na, bakit yun? Sige po, hintayin natin sila hanggang 8:30, ha? So, yung mga nanood ng class ko kagabi, like sa soils at saka sa crop science, congrats! Charot daw. Ayun. So, yun nila, may lumabas daw eh. Yan. Sana all may lumabas. Sana lagi tayong ganito, no? Lahat po tayo papasa. I mean, lagi po, lahat na lang ng dapat pinag-aaralan natin ay lumalabas sa exam. Kasi para hindi tayo lugi. Ayun. Bibilisan lang ni sir, no? Baka ano lang tayo. Mabibilisan ko lang talaga yung animal nutrition tsaka breeding and genetics. Tawagin ko yung mga estudyante ko sa taas, ha? We will wait until 8:30. Brian?
Sir.
Oh, akala ko tulog ka pa. Hi, King. Ikaw lang, hindi ko narinig kanina sa GC nag-ingay. Okay ka lang, King? Parang si King ata hindi naging kanina hello po. Yan. Hi to lahat sa mga YouTube. Ayan po, shout out po. Shout out. Kay Julian Bermudez, yan po. Hi, hello po. Hopefully nasagot niyo po ng mabuti yung ano niyo. And then nakapagpanood po kayo ng Ultimate Final Coaching ko po. Talagang may maisasagot po kayo talaga. Kasi all of my topics po are basics only. They are all basics. Okay, wala pong ano. Lahat po yan ay basics. Okay? And then, hi po kay kay Ma'am Early Tuwala. Hello po, good evening po. Ayan. And then, John Francis Gagno. Hi! Hi, thank you, Lord. At least po may nasagot po kayo. That's very important, no? And we pray na lang talaga. I-pray natin kay God na lahat po ay papasa. And then lahat po ng nasagot ninyo ay tama. Ayan. So, at least you already did your best. So, ang gawin na lang po natin, let's pray kung ano nga ba ang magiging result. Okay? So, hindi naman tayo papabayaan ni God. Just keep your faith burning. Just hold. No? Just hold with that faith. Yun. Kahit even a little faith, you should hold on it and believe on it. Yun. And then you pray for it. Okay? So, let's wait until 8:30 and then I'm going to switch over to my PC so that you can see our discussion for tonight. Okay? And the moment that you wonderful for me. Hi to all WEMSO students. Hi to all BSU out there and to other schools. Hello po sa inyong lahat. And yung mga nasa YouTube po, you can share the link to ano po sa mga GCs. Please, please share the link po. Yan. Hi. Yun po. Actually, kakatapos ko lang. Pasensya na po ha. Kakatapos. Supposed to be we have a class 8 alas 8 kasi nag-tutor pa si sir. Saglit lang. Si yung parents kasi ayaw mag, yung anak kasi niya ayaw magpaturo sa iba. Nasanay kasi sa akin. So, King, nakapasok ka na, King. Ayan na si King. Ano sa... Ah, nawala si King? Nawala si King?
Pero, Zer.
Huwag ka mula. Bakit ikaw hindi ka nag-iingay kanina sa grade sa GC?
Pa.
Bakit ano hindi ka nag-iingay sa GC kanina?
Tulog po.
Ah, si Risa natulog. I mean, si King. Si King, hindi na ano. Si King, hindi na ano na tawag dyan. Okay na yun, natulog kayo. Importante nakatulog para habang nagdi-discuss sir, hindi kayo makatulog, ha?
Opo.
Yan. Very good yan, kasi natulog po tayo. Ako hindi. Okay na sa akin, hindi matulog. Okay, so meron ako this tomorrow morning. So check your kindly check from time to time yung ano ninyo, yung inyong GC tomorrow morning, ha. Okay, kasi nga mayroon mga updates si sir regarding on the tawag diyan regarding on the kimutan ko na tuloy. Okay, regarding on the updates sa ano, sa animal science. Okay, so yun, tomorrow, alam na natin, napakahirap na exams tomorrow. Ayan, so, wait lang ha, saglit lang. Oh, inay-inay lang. Sige na, sige na. Salud, salud. I close the door because the aircon is turned out.
The banco is not, ano, fitting here.
Over there.
Over there, okay.
You put all your, ano.
I sit here, but, pagdali, dudong! Hey. Yo, so I open, sir, ang microphone. Open mo.
Ay, nakon pala, sorry.
Yamara, magkawin.
I-remove ko na sa YouTube. Pero mo, iyo, sige lang. Okay lang na. Yama-yama lang. Actually, guys, mga Bisaya, halos dito. Ayan. Okay. Andito na sila, Justin. Yes, nakapasok. Ala, nakatulog siguro yun. Nakatulog siguro si Justin. Just, no. Andito na. Akala ko nakatulog. Okay, so, nakapagpahinga naman kayo, no? Okay, let's start. Okay, so tonight, our discussion is animal nutrition. Tulog kayo kung palanggang. Lamig yung tulog. Tinod naman. Did I add this one? Gio natulog.
Hindi ka po siya.
Actually po, na okay, yung PDF ko, yung Rationally, andun na po, check the Google Drive, tapos click nyo the Rationally. Pag-click nyo ng Google Drive, direct yun siya, mag-redirect sa Rationally na folder. Andun po, Rationally number 3, yun. Sa Rationally number 3, andun po yung ano, yung PDF na yun. Okay?
Can you give me some?
mag-off cam lang ako. Kita mo? Okay, importante, ano na lang. So, yeah. Okay, you listen carefully, guys. Do not take note na lang kasi hindi naman yan, pag-take note kayo, wala namang, ano yan, hindi nyo naman yan mababasa tomorrow morning. So, ano na lang, makinig na lang kayo, mabuti sa akin. Okay, so, okay. Diba yan? Hindi tayo monitor. Pagalitan tayo ni YouTube nito. Yan. Sorry, maraming nanonood sa YouTube min. Hi, shout out. Hi, shout out. Yan.
Sir.
Ito sa mga
recorded ba 'to, sir?
Shout out na si Jason. Ayan. Annyeonghaseyo.
Recorded, sir.
Ha?
Recorded ba tayo?
Actually, hindi tayo recorded. Pero directly. Gusto niya i-record ko siya? Sige, record ko na lang.
Ayun, sir. Ayun yung kita, yung makulipo dyan.
Mag-off cam lang ako para hindi makita yung mga alipores ko sa likod.
May estudyante mo yan, sir.
Alipores, ha? Para hindi ko makita, para hindi niyo makita yung mga ano, oh, mga insect scale sa likod. Yung mga...
insect scale.
Insect scale.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Tayo na natin pag mag-approve na yung recording sa Gmail. Si Jay, gusto ka daw nila makita, Jay.
Nag-request
sila
na
ba ka?
Hoy!
Okay.
Jay, I want to see your face.
And I want to see your face now, Jay. Ah.
Bit lang mo na naka-ubad ako eh.
Agoy, naka-ubad.
Okay.
Okay lang daw. Okay, so let's start now because it's already it's about to, ano, kasi sabi ni sir, wag lang po sana tayo abot ng 12, sabi pa ni Sir Kimberly, magta-try po tayo ng best natin, sir, ha, na hindi tayo abot ng 12. Okay, kasi alam ko naman, diniscuss na natin yan. O, oh, tignan niyo, ang gwapo, oh! Woo! Nawala bigla. Ayan. Ayan. Alam ko naman na sa private class ko ay na-discuss na namin ito ng paulit-ulit. Ayun, ng paulit-ulit. Tapos, at the same time, pinamemorize ko sa kanila to. So, Sharo, wala pa may matubag ano sa board exam dong. So, dapat, na-adjun may matubag, no? Meron talaga kayong ano, masagot. Yun, dapat may sagot talaga kayo. So, ayan. Okay? So, congrats sa inyong lahat ng mga nakasagot. Hi po. Ayan. So, tomorrow again, meron din tayo which is economics and extension. So, doon, mas 40 units, sir. Yun, mas marami akong tips na bibigay doon. Okay? So, yan. Mag-off cam na po ako. Okay, let's start. Okay. So, saan na ba tayo? Okay. So, these are the minerals that we need to know. Okay, so let's start first with the fat-soluble vitamins. So what are those fat-soluble vitamins? Those are vitamins called ADEC. ADEC. Okay, it's vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K. So there are the important vitamins that we need to know. Kasi nga, lumalabas din sa board exam. Kanina, lumabas yung mga macro and micro minerals. I thought na naalala pa ng mga estudyante ko. Some of them naalala daw nila. Ang iba, hindi na daw nila naalala. Okay, so kaya comfortable ako na hindi siya i-discuss. No? So dapat pala yung discuss ko lang madami. Okay, so it's okay. Babawi tayo for tomorrow. Babawi tayo. Okay, babawi tayo. So we have vitamins which is fat soluble, the ADEC. Okay, do not forget that. Pag sinabing vitamin A, it means retinol. Okay, pag sinabing retinol, it talks about the epithelial tissues. Okay, so pag sinabing vitamin A or retinol, promotes the development of visual pigments. Saan ito usually located? Sa eyes. Yan, sa eyes. Yan, para makita mo, no? Para makita ng crush mo yung kahalagahan niya sa iyo. Kailangan niya ng vitamin A. Okay? Para makita, okay? Hi, shout out Mark from La Union. Ayun. Sorry. Okay, kailangan ng ano para makita ng crush mo yung ano niya, yung halaga mo, dapat no, bigyan mo ng vitamin A, hindi rubas ha. Iba 'yun. That's another thing. Hindi yung pang vitamin A. Yung vitamin A, yun yung mga visual pigments. Okay? So, also, pag vitamin A, no, it is indispensable for the formation and protection of epithelial tissues. Kailangan po yan para sa epithelial tissues. We know that there's a lot of, we have four types of tissues, right? So, we have connective tissues, muscle tissues, ano pa, madaming klaseng tissues. And one of them are epithelial tissues. So, epithelial tissues is needed a vitamin A, which is known as retinol. Kasi nga, sa epithelial tissues, we have what we call may mga epithelial tissues, there are actually three types. No? Meron tayong straight, you know, if I'm not mistaken, meron tayong single tissue siya na epithelial tissues, yung manipis lang, tapos may double, yon. So,
smooth cell.
Hindi ko alam yung straighted ba yung term nun?
Straighted din, tsaka...
Yes, straighted term. Yeah, tama. Pag straighted, yon. So, usually yung epithelial tissues located yan siya sa GI tract. Okay, sa GI tract, meron din yan. Tsaka sa urinary bladder, meron din yan yung mga epithelial tissues dyan. Okay, so that's why it needs vitamin A para maging healthy si epithelial tissues and can fight and can stretch. Kasi stretchable kasi si epithelial tissues. Okay, and then we have improved resistance to infections. That's why vitamin A yung ginagamit ng hayop, no? Nag-improve yung kanyang resistance sa kung ano man mga infection or diseases na pumasok sa kanya, it is tolerance to that diseases. Okay? So they are resistance to that diseases because it can boost their immune system. Okay? Pag vitamin A. See? Hindi lang siya, no? Hindi lang siya para sa mata, hindi lang siya sa epithelial tissues, but also to improve or boost your immune system. Ngayon, saan pa pwedeng makakuha? Or so where are the natural occurrences of vitamin A? Actually, you can find vitamin A sa mga green crops. Yun, sa mga green crops, sa mga fish liver oil. Yun, that is rich in vitamin A. What else? Sa liver, sa egg yolk. Yun. Sa egg yolk, di ba, vitamin rich in vitamin A yun siya. And then sa milk, meron din tayong vitamin A sa milk, sa dairy, at sa mga dairy products. That's where you can get a vitamin A. Okay? Next is we have the vitamin D, which is part of fat-soluble vitamins, which is the ADEC. Vitamin D meaning calciferol. Calciferol, okay, calciferol, meaning from the word itself, calci, it's in German, that is calci, calcium, yun. Okay, so regulates the incorporation of calcium and phosphorus, okay, into the bone. Saan yung target niya? Into the bone matrix. Okay, that's the main function of the vitamin D, calciferol, into the bone matrix, and calcium absorption from the intestinal lumen. Okay, from the intestinal lumen. Okay, so we're going to We're going to break down the definition. Actually, vitamin D, okay, calciferol, which is concerned in the bone. Kasi we know naman that the main creation or the main creation of the blood is actually in the bone, no? Which is found in the spongy bone, okay? Which is kailangan talaga yan ng ating bones ang vitamin D. Okay, so that's why we drink milk. Okay, so kasi nga ang milk is rich in calcium. Okay, so it is regulates the incorporation of calcium and phosphorus into the bone matrix. Always remember, bone matrix. Okay, and calcium absorption from the intestinal lumen. Bakit kailangan ni intestinal lumen ang calcium? Because the intestinal lumen is the one where it is found the absorption function of the nutrients. Okay, it's that's being digested by our stomach, yun, or a true stomach. Okay, next is we have the yan, para makita ninyo ako, on cam, yun. And we have vitamin E. Pag sinabing vitamin E, that is what we call tocopherol. No, it's tocopherol. It's toco, ganun. It's tocopherol. It's toco. Yan, that is tocopherol. So by the way, saan ka makakakuha? Where is the natural occurrences of the vitamin D? Okay, going back tayo dun sa vitamin D muna ha. Saan ba usually, okay, ang occurrences? O, balikan natin yung slides, baka maguluhan kayo. Saan yung occurrences ng vitamin D? Saan kayo makakuha ng vitamin D? You can get from the sun-dried green forage. Okay, sun-dried green forage. Or pwede sa fish liver oil. Okay, pwede din sa eggs, yun, sa milk, sa dairy products. You can get a calcium or vitamin D from those occurrences. Okay, and now let's proceed to vitamin E, which is the tocopherol. Tocopherol. Yan, toco. So yun na lang, alalahanin nyo, toco, yung sabi ni Sir toco, tocopherol po yun. Okay, so what do you mean by vitamin E or tocopherol? It works as biological antioxidant. Okay, it is antioxidant. Kaya nga minsan pag may makita tayo ng mga product, it rich in antioxidant, ganun. So it means that it rich in vitamin E. Okay, so it is not just only as antioxidant, but also it detoxifying agent. No, it is as a detoxifying agent and participate as a component of the respiratory chain. So that also the purpose of vitamin E. Meaning tinatanggal yung mga toxicity sa katawan mo. Especially if you are fatty, no, you have a lot of toxics in your body. Okay, so that's why you go exercise, you take mga dietary medicine supplements, ganon. So that is vitamin E or tocopherol. Okay, and other than that, that vitamin E also is a functions in nucleic acid metabolism and in endocrine glands. So bakit siya function? Ang vitamin E sa endocrine glands, bakit kailangan siya ng endocrine glands? We know that endocrine glands is producing hormone or a chemical activators. Okay, so bakit nag-produce siya ng hormone? Because the hormone is the one na boosting or giving us parang may gana tayong magtrabaho, yun. May gana tayong gawin yung mga bagay na gusto nating gawin. Okay? So minsan, pag aggressive yung partner natin, pag kailang dalawa sa room, tapos aggressive yung partner natin, ibig sabihin, mataas yung hormone niya. Mataas yung hormone niya. Okay, dinadaya kayo ng hormone pag kinikilig po kayo. Okay, dinadaya kayo ng hormone ninyo pag kinikilig kayo. May kinikilig pa ba ngayon? Siguro wala nang kinikilig ngayon ng dahil sa ano. Siguro pag nag-iihi ka na lang, umihi ka na, hindi ka nakakapil ng kilig. Nakakapil ng kilig. Kasi hindi na kami nakikilig, sir. Kinikilig kasi kinakabahan na sila tomorrow for animal science. Where? Expect that there will be a computations question in animal science tomorrow. So prepare for that. So I hope you already memorized the gestation period. So you should memorize all the gestation period from the ruminants, non-ruminants, poultry, so especially the hatchery period. So incubation period, dapat alamin po ninyo yun. Okay? So kasi yan na lumalabas sa exam. Okay? And aside from that, saan ba nakakuha ng vitamin E? Where is the natural occurrences? Saan ka ba nakakahanap ng vitamin E? You can found it in the green crops. Okay, marami yan. Sa green crops, sa cereal germs, yan. cereal germs po, cereal, okay, cereal grains yan. May milling, myling of myling byproducts sa pwede siya sa mga rice, corn, ganoon. You can get vitamin E from that. And then sa leafy vegetables, ayan, and then some animal organs also you can get a vitamin E, and then and also the milk butter. Okay? So you can get a vitamin E. And also, hindi ko makalimutan, pagtocopperol or vitamin E is also concerned with the integumentary system. It has also function with the integumentary system. So what is integumentary system? It talks about the study of your skin. Okay? Your epidermis and dermis. No? Because there is a deposit tissue in the parts of the integumentary system, which is ikatatlong part siya. Ang labas is epidermis. Second is the dermis. In the dermis, there where you can see the capillaries, the hair roots, the sweat gland, the oil gland, andun yun, okay, sa dermis. And then sa below of the dermis, diyan po makikita si adipose tissue. Si adipose tissue po ay composed of fibrinogen, if I'm not mistaken. It's fibrinogen, which is, it is composed of a lot of more fats yun. So dun po, nagsistack yun. Hindi agad-agad na organs ang makikita ninyo. Still, there are tissues, okay, that is coated before the organs. Okay? So always remember that. Okay? So vitamin E helps in the skin or integumentary system. Okay? Baka lumabas din po yan sa board exam. And, now let's proceed to vitamin K. So vitamin K naman, also, meron din po, makakabili po kayo ng vitamin E from citrus family. Yun, sa mga citrus family, meron din po yan. Okay, that will boost your vitamin, yung ano nyo, yun. That is actually applicable for human. What if, kaya lumabas yan sa exam. Okay, so what if kung ang inyong hayop ay nagkaroon ng sakit na dermatitis, yun. Nagkaroon ng sakit na dermatitis. So are you going to apply more citrus? Citrus pipiguin ng sipipiguin magpapapuga ng ano ng citrus tapos ilalagay sa ano. That's not the thing na ano. Actually in cultural method ang ginagawa yan ng mga matatanda ay yung dahon ng mga citrus tulad ng ano yung buungon. Are you familiar with buungon?
What's buungon in English?
Pomelo. Pomelo, yun. Pomelo. Okay, so yung mga yung dahon ng pomelo, so yung dahon ng pomelo tinatawag nila binaboil ata yun nila.
Yes, yun,
pinapakuluan nila, tapos pinapaliguan nila doon sa, ano nila, sa hayop nila. Actually, I have also that, kasi may sakit na dermatitis para magaling daw yun. Kasi, it's either meron siyang, ano ba yun, means ba yun na term? Yung maliliit na, mga diseases, yun, na usually sakit talaga siya ng aso. Yun. Actually, ang ginamit din namin, ang ginamit namin is madre de cacao, yun. Madre de cacao para mabalik yung skin ng aso namin. So, yun ang ginawa namin. Pinaliguan namin siya ng madre de cacao. Okay? So, is kasi yung madre de cacao din siya, mag-boost din siya sa, it will improve your, the dermal tissue of the animals. And then we have vitamin K. Okay, pag sinabing vitamin K, we have menadione. Okay, menadione. Okay, mena. Si mena ay isang vitamin K. Yun. May mena, dione. Si mena ay isang vitamin K. So what is the function of vitamin K or the mena dione? The functions in the blood coagulation system. That is the main function of the vitamin K. The function is the blood coagulation. Ano yung blood coagulation? It is the circulatory system. Okay? It is concerned with the blood clotting. Okay? If I'm not mistaken, it is concerned with the blood clotting. Okay, vitamin K or menadione, okay? And then, pag blood coagulation, it talks about the blood clotting or boosting your, ano yung tawag dun? Ano nga yung platelets, another term?
Thrombocytes.
Thrombocytes, yun. It's thrombocytes. And then we have vitamin K acts in the maturation of the bone structure. Okay. Kasi marami nagtatanong, bakit yung vitamin K, sir, instead of vitamin D, ang acts in the maturation of bone structure? Diba sinabi ko sa'yo kanina that in the bone also, there is the main function of the production of the blood. Okay, dyan yan sa bone nakikita, which is, if I'm not mistaken, sa spongy bone. Okay, tapos, kailangan kasi yun ng vitamin K. Bakit? Kasi nga, yun nga, acts in the maturation of bone structure. Kasi pag in the making of the blood sa bone, okay, so kailangan maging matured muna yung bone bago siya mag-produce ng another new blood. Yun, ganun. New blood or bagong dugo, yun. So kailangan meron siyang enough vitamin K. Okay, so that is why vitamin K also acts in the maturation of the bone structure. Okay? Ayan. Hi! Hi, Ma'am Francis Kapayan. You're welcome. You're welcome. Yeah, Gwen Chanay, oh. Ayan. So, saan ka makakuha ng vitamin K? O sinasabi natin, menadione. So, makakuha ka or you can get it from green forage. Yun. Sa mga liver oils, pwede din. Okay, sa green vegetables, sa potatoes, pwede din po yan, sa potato. And then fruits, yun, sa fruits. Actually, pagkakaalam ko talaga, basta sa tao ha, papaya, yun, sa papaya, pwede din. Pwede din yun siya. Lalo na pag nagka-dengue, yun, nagka-dengue yung anak mo, yun. So, pakainin mo ng papduga ba yun ang papaya? Bakbok, ang leaves.
Flower. Ah, flower.
Basta yung squeeze mo siya, tapos yung duga niya, yun. Because it rich in, it boosting the blood coagulation. Yes, kasi magbaba man yung platelets niya. So dapat yun. Isa din yun, that is a cultural method or traditional method, pero effective yun. Aside from that, they also drink tawa-tawa, if I'm not mistaken. Dawa-dawa. Yun, isa din po yun. Okay? Yun, and more fruits, like, mangga, yun. Saging, yan. Saging is, lalo na pag ano, pag you are feeling dizzy, you eat saging. If you eat saging, you feel not dizzy anymore. Your blood circulation will be normal. So, dapat yun. Kasi isa din yun sa mga, it's proven and tested. Because I've been dizzy before. Tapos, nagkain lang ako ng ilang saging, nabalik ulit siya. Para nawawala yung dizzy ko. Yun. So that is under vitamin K. And next is, now we are going to talk about the water soluble. Ibig sabihin ng water soluble, no, isasama sa water or mimic sa water para pwedeng ma-intake ng hayop. Okay? So what is vitamins? We have the fat soluble and the water soluble. Pag fat soluble, it can only be soluble or matutunaw lang siya through fats. While a water soluble, it can be matunaw siya through water or pwede nyo isama dun sa mga iniinom ng inyong hayop. Okay, and then we have vitamin B1. Okay, what is vitamin B1? It is known as thiamine. Okay, it is thiamine. It participates in the process of carbohydrates metabolism. Bakit siya participates in the process of carbohydrate metabolism? Always remember ha, yung mga vitamin B, okay, or water soluble, actually, dumadaan po sila sa bloodstream, including the vitamins also. Sa bloodstream po sila dumadaan kasama si hormones. Okay? So, not just the water soluble, not just the fat soluble, but also the minerals. Okay? And also the hormones that is passes through bloodstream. Okay? So, vitamin B1 or thiamine participates in the process of carbohydrates metabolism. So, there are deficiency if mababa ang carbo mo or mataas or mag-exist yung carbo mo. So, meron po silang mga deficiency pa ganun. Okay, so where can you get? Saan ka nakakakuha ng vitamin B1 or thiamine? You can get it from cereal germs, myelin products, oil cakes, pwede po yun. Yeast, yan, sa yeast. Yan, lumabas daw kanina yung yeast eh. Yes, fungi, mycorrhiza, and then mushroom. So, hindi ko na nasagutin ko ano yung tamang sagot doon. Because the question is referring to mycelium. It is a true fungi. There's no other true fungi po. Alam nyo na yung sagot doon. Alam nyo na yung sagot nun. There's no other true fungi. Hindi ko na sabihin kung sino yun. Wala pa ibang true fungi doon. Okay, so, yung mga private class ko lang nila yun yung true fungi. Kilala nila sa true fungi. Okay, so, example doon ay si Blank. Okay, so now let's focus to B1. Saan ka makakuha ng B1, vitamin B1? Sa cereal germs. Yan, milling products, oil cakes, yeast. Yan, cereals, yon, vegetables, potatoes, fruits, animal organs, egg yolk, and milk. So you can get it from there, okay? Yung mga vitamin B1. Next, you have the vitamin B2. Okay, vitamin B2 is also known as riboflavin. Okay, it's riboflavin, which means that acts in the respiratory chain. Saan yung respiratory chain? That is part in the pulmonary circulation. So acts in the respiratory chain as a constituent of the flavin enzymes concerned with hydrogen transfer. Okay, so that is vitamin B2 oil or riboflavin. Okay, acts in the respiratory chain as a constituent of the flavin enzymes concerned with hydrogen transfer. So ano, kasi alam naman natin na sa respiratory chain, andiyan yung exchange or gas exchange, di ba? Or exchange of gas, no, that is happened in, what is the basic unit, the smallest unit of respiratory system? No. Alveoli? It's not alveoli. It's... Can you still remember, ano, Jason? The basic unit of respiratory system? Bisa, pagkatapos ng alveoli? Ano yun? Hindi pa. Meron pa talaga pinakamaliit. Oo. Kung saan yung exchange of gas?
Alveoli. Okay, sir.
Ha? Saan yun, Steph?
Bronchios, I'm not sure.
Ano daw? Hindi ko maintindihan. Nanapin ko, ha? Hindi lagi. Check natin. Alveoli. Okay. So we have the alveoli. Meron talaga yung sa unit. If I'm not mistaken. Okay. It's alveoli. Respiratory unit of lungs is called alveoli. Yun. Ah, iba pala yun. It's alveoli. Tama. It's alveoli. Okay. So we have alveoli. So the basic unit of the smallest unit of the respiratory system is alveoli. Okay, so we have vitamin B2, riboflavin yun. Isa din yun siya sa pinaka-importanting gawin kasi nga nagkakaroon ng exchanging of the gas there. So that's why kailangan siya for the transfer of hydrogen. Okay, yung vitamin B2. Saan ka nakakuha ng vitamin B2 or riboflavin? You can get it from some oil seeds, yun. Yeast, brewery, byproducts, yun. Vegetables, fish meal, yun. Meat and bone meals, yun. Skim milk. Pwede din makuha sa liver, sa kidney, sa eggs, yon, sa milk, dairy, and other dairy products. Okay? So that's where you can get a vitamin B2. And next, we have the vitamin B6. We have the pyridine. Okay?
Pyridine.
Yan. It's pyridine. Or it's like pyridine. And then pyridine. It's not pyridine. Okay, it's okay. So we have vitamin B6, or also known as active in amino acid metabolism, as a coenzyme of several enzyme system. So ang vitamin B6 so para siyang assistant, no, ng mga enzyme system, no, because they make the amino acid metabolism active. Okay, so that's the work of vitamin B6. Okay, so where can you get a vitamin B6? From the greens, milling byproducts, oil cakes, yeast, cereal, grains, vegetables, red meat, yan. Red meat, liver, egg yolk, milk. You can get a vitamin B6. When it comes to active in amino acid metabolism in the several enzyme system, that is vitamin B6. Okay? And next, we have the vitamin B12, or also known as cyanocobalamin. Okay? Cyanocobalamin. If I'm not mistaken, meron talaga siyang ibang term. It's it starts with letter T. Hindi, meron talaga. It starts with letter T. Kung makaremember ka, Steph, another name of B12, it starts with letter T.
Cyanocobalamin, rakun ba answer?
It's not cyanocobalamin. There's another term. Of ano Ay, Tocoperol. Not Tocoperol. It's lang vitamin. It's not cobalamin. Meron talaga siya ibang name pa talaga. Ano ba yun? Hindi ko na maalala. It starts with letter T. Lord, ipaalala mo sa akin. Ano ba yun? Thiamine. Meron yun. So, napin ko lang. So, meron yun. Meron siya sa sa mga question and answer.
Chef, tinatag mo
ako? Ha?
Tinatag mo ako?
Hindi. It's not cyan. No, hindi siya cyan, no, cobalamin. Iba pa talaga. Meron sa start with letter T. Na-remember mo pa yun, Jay? Yung letter T na ano, cyanocobalamin. Na ano, it starts with letter T na vitamin B12. Can you still remember that? It starts with letter T. Meron yan sa mga, ano, i-check mo ba yung ano? Tourmaline ata yun? It's tourmaline? Tourmaline ata yun? Check mo
ba siya yung cobalamin?
Ha?
Hindi ba yun yung other name niya?
Hindi. Ano ba yun? Normally, alam mo, basta it's vitamin B12. It starts with letter T.
Letter T.
Kaya hanapin ko. Hanapin ko talaga yan. Siya yung solo. Letter T. May ibang term pa talaga siya. It's other than cyan, parang tourmaline ata yun. It's tourmaline. Although tourmaline crystals are excellent for balancing. Tourmaline? Meron yan eh. Naka-encounter ako niyan. It's letter T. It starts with letter T. Baka ma-encounter ninyo yan sa board exam. Okay, so it starts with letter T, that is actually vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 yun, ibang name din siya ng vitamin B12. Tourmaline talaga na sa isipan ko. Ganon, so it's letter T, it starts with letter T. Okay, so we have, yun, so what's the work of vitamin B12? Or the cyanocobalamin? We have, it is essential in the reduction of 1-carbon compounds in the fat, and protein metabolism. Okay, yun ang trabaho ni cyanocobalamin. We have essential siya for the reduction of the fats, no? At least 1-carbon compounds in the fats and protein metabolism of the animals. So that's the work of vitamin B12. Okay? Ay, sumagot. It's not cobalamin. It's starts with letter T. Iba din po yung tetracycline.
Biotic. Ano?
Okay, so yun. Sige, hanapin ko lang yun. Basta it starts with tourmaline. Tignan niyo yung ano niyo, yung booklet niyo. Meron yun doon.
Three
booklet. I mean animal nutrition, check mo nga, Jay.
Si sir.
Do you have yung pay booklet diyan? Mao na niyo animal nutrition. Animal. Meron yun eh. It's tourmaline, if I'm not mistaken, like ganun. The term is T. It starts with letter T. Kasi lumabas yun sa board exam eh. Lumabas yun sa board exam yung ano na yun. Ibang term talaga siya ng vitamin B12.
Animal science. Animal nutrition.
Animal nutrition. Wait ha, hanapin ko muna ha. Wait, hindi talaga kasi pangat pag matulog pa, hindi naman natin yun na ano. Nasa isipan pa rin natin. Dali, hanapin ko yun. Animal tissue. Animal. Diyan yan. Animal nutrition. Animal nutrition. Hemoglobin. Kaya ang 1 point pag lumabas yan sa board exam. Starts with the letter T. Not one. Starts with the letter T. Trace minerals. We have all your enzymes. Sulfur.
Yeah, pala. Uto pala ito.
Ha? T. It starts with letter T. It starts with letter T. Saan kaya yun ha? Mahanap ko yun. Lord, saan ba yun? Meron yun. Nabasa ko yun.
Wala akong makita, sir, sa
booklet. Sige, ko. Isan ko na lang sa GC pag mahanap ko. Basta hindi siya mawala sa isipan ko. That's tourmaline something. Ganun. So, isa din yung show word. Okay, so pag sinabing essential in the relish of 1-carbon compounds in the fat and protein metabolism, so that's the work of vitamin B12. Example, pag masyadong fatty, yun, masyadong fatty yung inyong hayop and then wala nang balance between the fats, okay, the lipids and the carbo inside of the body of your ano, of your animal, so you need to take vitamin B12. Kailangan bigyan ng vitamin B12. Okay, and then we have next, and then we have vitamin H or dibiotin. Dibiotin is unnecessary for gluconeogenesis and fatty acid. Okay, necessary siya, importante for gluconeogenesis and fatty acid synthesis, where it acts in carboxylation reaction. Okay, it acts in carboxylation reaction. Okay, that is the vitamin H or biotin. Okay, kailangan siya for gluconeogenesis or gluconeogenesis and fatty acid synthesis. Okay, and then we have folic acid. Ito, folic acid acts in the 1-carbon metabolism. 1-carbon metabolism, where it is indispensable in the formation of amino acids and nucleic acids. So, kailangan siya for amino acids or in the formation of amino acids and nucleic acid. Okay? So, kailangan si folic acid. Okay? Metabolism of formation of amino acid and nucleic acid. Okay, yun. And then we have nicotinic acid. Okay, nicotinic acid acts as an active group of a different coenzyme, okay, which are related to the citric acid cycle. So, nicotinic is also related to citric acid cycle. Di ba napapansin ninyo, yung pinapainom niyo yung anak ninyo, yun, pinapainom ninyo yung mga anak ninyo, meron yung citric acid, tapos meron din po siyang nicotinic acid, yun. Those are the active group, mga active po sila. No, inactivate nila yung mga enzymes. They are coenzymes to activate a group of enzymes. Okay? And then we have pantothenic acid. Okay? Pantothenic acid is also a vitamins. Okay? This is a water-soluble vitamins, which means that pantothenic acid is part of coenzyme A. Okay? Which occupies a central position in the intermediary metabolism by activating weakly active acids. Anong gawa ni pantothenic? Ang gawa ni pantothenic ay occupy central position. Okay? And then intermediary metabolism by anong ina-activate niya? Yung weakly active acids. Yun ang ina-activate ni pantothenic. Okay? Yung weakly active acids. Other than that, As of this one, lumalabas din to sa exam ang pantothenic acid, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, pantothenic acid. Okay, to make it more explained, okay, pag sabing pantothenic or also known as the, is this the vitamin B5? Okay, yeah. Pantothenic acid or known as the vitamin B5, okay, is one of the eight B vitamins, yon. All B vitamins help the body convert food, carbohydrate, into fuel or glucose, which the body uses to produce energy. So this pantothenic acid vitamins, this B vitamins often referred to be as B complex vitamins, also help the body use fats and protein. Yun. Si pantothenic, conversion of fats to protein and then protein to fats. Yun. That is pantothenic acid. Next, we have, okay, vitamin C. Okay, vitamin C is, yeah, I gotta get it. Okay, so vitamin C naman is, yeah, essential in the formation and maintenance of skeletal tissue. Yan. Participation of an oxidation reduction system powered and cellular oxidation involved in the defensive mechanism. Bakit siya involved in the defensive mechanism? Example, yung hayop ninyo magkaroon ng scurvy, yung hayop ninyo magkaroon ng anong sakit ba yan? Sipon, ubo. So kailangan ay bigyan ninyo ng vitamin C or ascorbic acid para defensive mechanism, i-boost yung immune system. Okay? So that is the work of vitamin C. Ayun, nagets na, meron na. Okay. Yung vitamin B12 po. Thank you very much, Mark Adamson, Caleb. Yun po. It's transcobalamin. Yun. It's transcobalamin. That is transcobalamin. Or also known as tourmalin. Yun. Transcobalamin or also known as tourmalin. Yan. Nagets ka. Tama talaga. It's tourmalin talaga yun. Transcobalamin. Yan. Lamin. Cobalamin. Perfect. Thank you very much. Or actually, it also called tourmalin. Yun. Yan. Transcobalamin. Yun. And then, yun. Sa B12. Yun ang hinahanap ko actually. And then, we have next is the vitamins. So, we are done with the vitamins. We are done with the water soluble and the fat soluble. Okay. So, now let's proceed to macro minerals. So what are those macro minerals of the animals? We have calcium, chlorine and sodium, and then magnesium, phosphorus, potassium, sulfur. They are the macro elements. So this one is macro. So we are now going to discuss about macro minerals. Okay, macro minerals, which is calcium, the function is in the bone and teeth formation. So 90% of body calcium in the bones and teeth. Okay? So that is calcium. Aside from that, nerve and muscle function. Yan din si calcium. At saka acid-base balance. Nangyayari din po yan sa kidney. Okay? And then milk production sa mammary gland and also egg production in the infundibulum. Okay? So that is yan, infundibulum of the poultry, yun. So that is the function of the calcium. So what is deficient in calcium? For example, deficient, nagkulang ng calcium, anong sakit? So actually, dalawa yun. Pwedeng sayang at saka, makinig kayo, lalabas sa exam, yang at saka sa old. Okay? Anong sakit pag sayang, anong sakit pag nagkulang ng calcium, deficient sa calcium, anong sakit? Since it is rickets. Pag young, rickets. Okay, pag older, ano?
Osteomalacia, sir.
Very good. It's osteomalacia. Osteomalacia. So that is in the order. Bakit sayang nagkakaroon din po ng rickets? O si bata pa po yan siya. Bakit mo siya nagkakaroon ng rickets? Example po, na pag nagkaroon ng deficiency sa calcium, ang bata, ang piglets, Okay? Nagkakaroon po ng deformation sa bone. Okay? Nagkaroon ng deformation sa bone. Pag nagkaroon po ng deformation sa bone, tapos yung bone po ay soft, smooth, so, ibig sabihin po, may sakit siya na deficient sa calcium. Ang tawag sa yang na yan ay rickets. Okay? Di ba nakita ninyo, may ganun ang paa, yung tiko, yung parang ganun zombie-zombie. And then you have older naman, osteomalacia. Ano nangyayari pag tumatanda na, nagdi-deficient sa calcium, ang nangyayari sa bones ay nagiging porous. Ano ibig sabihin ng porous? Maraming butas-butas sa loob ng bones, tapos nagiging weak na. Yun, di ba? So yun po, maraming butas-butas, porous or weak, that is osteomalacia. Sa rickets naman, deformation ng bone, at saka soft ang bone. Okay? So that is calcium. Okay? Huwag kalimutan, nalabas yan sa board exam, kawawa kayo. Okay, next, we have chlorine and sodium. So chlorine and sodium, the work of chlorine and sodium, the function is in the formation of digestive juices. Okay, formation of digestive juices. So maraming digestive juices. We have chyme, if I'm not mistaken, intestinal juice. Okay, so in the chyme, ang chyme po is made up of gastric juice at saka pepsin. Pepsin is an enzyme also. So that equals to chyme. Okay? So that is in the digestive juices. And then control of body fluid concentration. So si chlorine and si sodium is control of body fluid concentration. And then si chlorine din and si sodium, control of body fluid pH. That's pH actually. That is potential hydrogen. Kinokontrol ang body fluid ng potential hydrogen. And then, we have also nerve and muscle activity. Yan. Nerve and muscle activity, ginagamit naman si chlorine and sodium. Now, ano nga ba ang deficiency pag nagkulang ng chlorine and sodium? No? Pwede ka magkaroon ng unthrifty appearance and impaired performance. Kasi nga, nerve and muscle activity, pwede ka magkaroon ng unthrifty performance. Appearance. Unthrifty appearance. Yun, parang abnormality sa appearance. At saka, pwede magkaroon ng hayop ng impaired performance. Yun, impaired performance. Impairment. Yun. And then, with heavily perspiring animals. So, an acute salt deficiency, kasi ito salt. Okay, the sodium here and the chloride. Then you have the sodium here, which is the salt here. So, pag nag-deficient ka sa salt, may develop resulting in disruptive nerve and muscle function and possible nervous prostration. Magkaroon yung hayop ng nervous prostration. Pag lack of salt. Okay? So, that is under chlorine and sodium. Okay, next, we have magnesium. Magnesium naman, necessary for... Okay, ay, sorry. Wala, mali to. Okay, sorry, mali to. Mali to, this is not the true definition of magnesium. Okay, the definition of magnesium, hindi ito ha. Okay, huwag nyo itong pansinin. The function of magnesium is necessary for many enzyme systems. Kailangan siya for enzyme, okay, systems. And then, plays role in carbohydrate metabolism. Okay, it plays role in the carbohydrate metabolism. So that is magnesium, okay? And then, other than that, magnesium, necessary for the proper functioning of the nervous system. Kailangan siya for the functioning of the nervous system. Okay, so that is magnesium. Okay, so enzymes, carbohydrate, and then metabolism, and then nervous system. So anong mangyari pag nag-deficient sa magnesium? Possible na magkaroon ng hypermagnesemic tetany. Okay, hyper... Okay, magne kay magnesemic tetany. Okay, tetany. Okay? Okay, so it is a hyper irritability of the neuromuscular system producing hyperextability or incoordination. So it talks about the incoordination of the nervous system yan. Incoordination. So that is hypermagnesemic tetany. Okay, next you have phosphorus. You have phosphorus for bone and teeth formation also. Si calcium 99%, si phosphorus naman about 80% of the body. Phosphorus is in the bones and the teeth. Okay, so sino mas mataas sa kanila? Si calcium kasi 99%. Si phosphorus 80%. So phosphorus as a component of protein in the soft tissues. Okay, component of protein in the soft tissues and phosphorus in the milk production, also in the egg production. Kailangan din siya. And in various metabolic processes. Okay, that is phosphorus. So, ano mangyari pag may deficient sa phosphorus? In young animals, magkaroon ng rickets. Okay, ulitin natin. Magkaroon siya ng rickets pag magkaroon ng deficient sa phosphorus in young animals. Okay, magkaroon ng rickets. It has a similar with the calcium. Kasi nga, they have the same function. Deficiency. And then, osteomalacia naman. Osteomalacia and osteoporosis sa mga matatanda. Okay? Osteomalacia. Okay, and then, or osteoporosis. Osteoporosis sa mga older animal. Siyon. That is because they are similar with the deficiency in calcium. So ano pa ganito po 'yan. Pag nagkaroon din ng deficient sa phosphorus, maglo-loss ang appetite, no? There will be a poor appetite, slow gaining or the growth maging mag-slow, lowered ang milk production, low ang blood and chew on non-feed objects tapos okay, so but it's not a specific for phosphorus deficiency. So we have phosphorus deficiency. Yung pinakaano talaga is loss in appetite, yon, slow gaining or growth, and then lowered milk production. So that is under phosphorus. Okay? Next, you have potassium. Okay? Potassium required by livestock. Kailangan siya ng livestock for a variety of body functions such as osmotic relations, acid-base balance, yan, rumen digestion, and the primary intracellular cation in neuromuscular activity. So that is potassium. Okay? So, ano mangyari pag nagkaroon ng deficiency sa potassium? Most unlikely under ordinary conditions, ang nangyari is that ang symptoms of deficiency ng potassium is decrease in feed consumption. Pagbaba ng feed consumption. Okay? Feed consumption and then lowered feed efficiency. Mababa ang feed efficiency. Lowered feed efficiency. Okay? And then slow growth. Mahina ang paglaki. Okay? Slow growth. And then, stiffness. Yan, stiffness din po. Stiffness, magkaroon ng stiffness. And, emaciation. Yan, emaciation. Stiffness and emaciation that is under potassium. Okay? Huwag kalimutan. These are the deficiency. Feed consumption, lowered feed efficiency, slow growth, stiffness, and emaciation under the deficiency of potassium. Okay? Next, we have last macrominerals is the sulfur. Okay? Last macrominerals is the sulfur. Okay, so sulfur naman as a component of the amino acid, cysteine, and methionine, and the vitamins, biotin, okay, vitamins, biotin, and thiamine. In the synthesis of sulfur-containing amino acids in the rumen. Saan? Sa rumen. Sulfur that is containing amino acids found in the rumen. And sulfur in the formation of various body compounds. Okay? So what are the deficiency in sulfur? Ano magkakaroon? It's either magkakaroon ng they were going to experience seldom deficiency. Okay, under ordinary conditions, no, the deficiency will express itself a protein deficiency. So magkaroon ka ng protein, magkaroon ng hayop ng protein deficiency pag nag-lack ng pag-lack of or deficient in sulfur. So magkakaroon ng protein deficiency kasi it talks about amino acids in the sulfur. Okay? And then magkakaroon ng unthrifty, 'yon. Unthrifty condition and poor performance. 'Yun. Unthrifty conditions and poor performance. Hindi na siya good for breeding purposes pag ganun. So naintindihan ba ninyo ang macro minerals? Did you understand the macro minerals? Thumbs up if you understand the macro minerals. Very good. You understand the macro minerals. Mabilis masyado si sir. Pero okay lang po yan. Kaya as long as nadaanan natin. Para bukas, okay, na-discuss yan ni sir. Ganito yan, ganyan. Okay? Yun po yung magiging sakit. Okay? Pag sulfur, deficient sa sulfur, isipin nyo na protein deficiency yan agad-agad. Kasi it talks about the amino acids. Okay? Next, we have the microminerals. Pag sinabing microminerals, it cannot be synthesized by the body. So, kailangan po ay gamitan ng dietary foods or feeds. No? Kaya nga, feeds that rich in macro minerals, macro elements. Pero, ang mga micro elements or mga trace elements, they cannot be synthesized in the body. They can synthesize in the body of the animal. Meaning, hindi na kailangan ng dietary feed constituents. Okay? So, now, let's proceed to the micro, this is micro, cobalt. Okay, cobalt as a component of the vitamin B12 molecule. Yan, cobalt. Component siya ng vitamin B12 in the rumen synthesis of vitamin B12. So what is the deficiency? If nagkulang ng cobalt, there's a tendency na magkaroon ng malnutrition symptoms. Magkaroon ng malnutrition symptoms. So what are those malnutrition symptoms? Okay? So number one is poor appetite. Magkaroon siya ng poor appetite. Number two, unthriftness. Okay? Unthriftness. Isa din po yan. And then, ano pa? Weakness. Weakness. And ang pinakasikat talaga, pagkaroon ka ng deficiency ay anemia. Yun. Anemia. Pagkaroon ka ng deficiency in B12, magkaroon ng anemia. Ano pa mangyari? Decreased fertility. Pwede bumaba ang fertility rate. And then, slow ang growth niya. And then, mababa ang milk and wool production. Yun. Decrease in milk and wool production sa sheep. Okay? Wool production sa sheep. Okay? Isa yan. Pag deficient sa cobalt. Okay? Next. Copper. This is copper in iron absorption. Okay? Copper in iron absorption. Copper in hemoglobin formation. Kasi sa hemoglobin din, kailangan din ng iron yan. Okay? And then, copper in synthesis of keratin for hair and wool growth. And copper in various enzyme systems. Ito lang, focus natin. Okay? In hemoglobin formation, iron absorption, and synthesis of keratin for hair and wool growth. That is copper. So what is the deficiency of copper? Mababa, no? Low blood. Okay? Mababa ang dugo. Low blood and liver copper. Okay? Liver copper. Okay? Mababa blood and then liver copper. Tapos nagkakaroon ng bleaching. Bleaching of hair sa cattle. Bleaching of hair in cattle. Okay, huwag kalimutan yan. Baka lalabas sa exam yan. Bleaching of hair in cattle. Tapos, nagkakaroon ng abnormal wool growth. Abnormal. Abnormal sa wool growth. Okay? Wool growth. Okay? And then sa sheep po yan nangyayari. And then abnormal bone metabolism, muscular incorporation, tapos weakness at birth. Yun. Weakness at birth. At birth pala, at birth, at birth. Weakness at birth. And then magkakaroon ng anemia. Ayan, nagkakaroon ng anemia. So yan ang deficiency ng copper. Next, fluorine. What is deficiency of fluorine? Actually, F lang yan eh. It reduces incidence of dental, okay, dental cares in humans and possibly other animals. Okay? And then fluorine possibly retards osteoporosis in mature animals. So it retards osteoporosis in mature animals. So ano ang deficient ng fluorine? In children, magkakaroon ng excessive in dental caries. Okay, excessive in, yan, excessive in dentals. Yung magdami ba ang ano, oh, ngipin-ngipin? Di ba may mga excess ang ngipin, yung mga sumpay-sumpay, yung mga ano, that is caused by excessive or ano, deficient in fluorine. Yun, excessive in dental caries, yun. Magsumpay-sumpay ng ngipin, madami ngipin, yun, because of deficient in fluorine. And then we have iodine, this one. In the production of thyroxine by the thyroid gland, no, pag nag-lack ka, nagkulang ka ng, pag nagkulang ng iodine ang animal, may possible na magkakaroon siya ng goiter. Okay? Goiter at birth or soon thereafter. Pwedeng by birth or by after the birth. And then, dead or weak at birth. No? Dead, patay or mahina at birth. Hairlessness at birth, walang buhok. Yon, walang buhok or makonti lang ang buhok. Okay? And then, infected navel, especially in fowls or in fowls. So that is iodine. And then, we have iron. Yan. Iron, necessary for hemoglobin formation. Importante yun, ha? Sa blood, yan, sa blood. Necessary for hemoglobin formation. Essential for the formation of central enzymes related to oxygen transport and utilization. Also, iron enters into the formation of certain compounds which serve as iron stores in the body, especially ferritin found primarily in the liver and spleen. Saan nakikita ang iron? Sa liver and spleen. Okay? And hemosiderin found mainly in the blood. Okay? Mainly in the blood. So what happened with you? What happened with the animals that is deficient in iron? Possible in young pig. Okay? In young pig, sa mga batang piglet or baboy, in young pig, no, low, mababa ang blood. Okay? Mababa ang blood hemoglobin. Yan. Mababa ang blood hemoglobin. Tapos, labored breathing. Yun, labored breathing. Okay? Nahirapan huminga. Yon. And then, listlessness. Yan. Listlessness. Yan. Listlessness. Okay? Listlessness. And then, pale eyelids. Nagkakaroon ng pale eyelids or pamumutla ng eyelids. Okay? Pale eyelids. And then, ears and nose. And then, nagkakaroon ng flabby. Yan. Flabby. Pag deficient ng iron, wrinkled skin, yan, wrinkled skin. Kulang sa protina, kulang sa dugo, kulang sa iron, yun. Or edema of heat and shoulders. Yun, edema of heat and shoulders. Kaya nagkakaroon ka, nakaka-feel ka ng inflammation, isa din po yun. Okay? Okay, next is we have manganese. Okay, manganese in enzyme systems influencing estrus. Yun, manganese, gina-influence na yung estrus, ovulation, fetal development, other development, milk production, and growth and skeletal development. So that is the work of manganese in micro elements. Okay, ano pa mangyari if merong deficiency sa manganese, no? Delayed istrus. Yun. Delay. Kasi nga, influencing istrus siya dapat. So, magde-delay ang istrus kung mababa ang manganese. Yun. Ano pa? Reduce ovulation. May possibility na maging infertile ang ovum ng isang babae. No, reduce fertility, pwede pang hindi magkaanak o hindi makabuo ng offspring. Abortion, yung pinaka talaga, pinakaano ng manganese, magkaroon ng abortion kasi nga walang proper development ng udder. At the same time, hindi po protected ang cervix. Yon. And then, aside from that, deformed yang, pwede magkaroon ng deformed yang, and then poor growth, and then lower tissues, or other name is knuckling over in calves. So, ito yung pinakasikat talaga na deficient ng manganese sa calves ay knuckling over. Okay? Knuckling over. Sa ano po yan? Sa paa. Yan, knuckling over. Yan po ay sikat or common sa calves na deficient sa manganese. Yan. Okay? Nagets ninyo? Okay, next we have the molybdenum. Molybdenum is a component of enzyme xanthian oxidase, especially important to poultry for uric acid formation. So molybdenum is used for uric acid formation. Molybdenum for poultry, ito for poultry. Okay? And then we have selenium. Selenium in vitamin E absorption and utilization. So it is also essential compound, a component of enzymes, then glutathione peroxide, a peroxidase, and then which function to destroy toxic peroxides in the tissue, thereby having a sparing effect in the vitamin E requirement. So actually, si selenium naman po talaga, means sa vitamin E, parang assistant siya, no, in the vitamin E. Kasi nga, microelements lang siya. So yun, other compounds of selenium seem to work in concert with vitamin E. Yun, concert with vitamin E, kasama with the vitamin E. So, kailangan siya for the maintenance of the normal cell function and the membrane health. Yun, maintenance of the normal cell function and the membrane health. And then we have the zinc. Okay, zinc. By the way, ano ang deficient ng selenium? Pwede magkaroon ng dystrophy. Okay, nutritional muscular dystrophy. Yun. Or white muscle disease. Yun. Sa selenium, pwede magkaroon ng nutritional muscular dystrophy or also known as white muscle disease. Magkaroon ng deficient sa selenium. So, saan yan usually nakikita? Sa lambs at saka sa calves. Okay? Ano pa? Retained placenta in cows. Tapos heart failure. Selenium. Pag deficient sa selenium, magkaroon ng heart failure. Paralysis. Pwede din po yun. Deficient ng selenium. Poor growth. Low fertility. Liver necrosis. Yun sa selenium yun. And then pancreatic fibrosis in chicks. Magkaroon ng pancreatic fibrosis in chicks. And then we have zinc. Okay, zinc naman prevents parakeratosis. Yun. It prevents the parakeratosis. Ang zinc promotes general thriftiness and growth. Promotes wound healing. Related to hair and wool growth and health. And then deficiency impairs testicular growth and function. So sa testicle. Yan. Deficiency impairs testicular growth and functions. So what is the deficiency of zinc? No, frequently experiencing in growing and fattening. Swine being fed on concrete with rations containing recommended levels of calcium. Yun. So pag nag-exist ng calcium po, pag nasobraan, pwede din mangyari ito. Okay? Deficient sa zinc. Okay? So what are the symptoms of the deficiency of zinc? No, parakeratosis. Yun. Kaya nga piniprevent niya, parakeratosis. And then, general unthriftiness. And then, poor growth. Unhealthy looking hair sa wool. Yun. And then, slow wound healing. Yung parang alternate lang siya ng function ng zinc. Okay? So, ganun po ang deficiency ng zinc. Do you have any questions with the minerals and vitamins? So those are micro minerals. Okay, nagets ba ninyo? Hi, thank you, Tilus. Hi, Ma'am Tilus. Sorry. Thank you, Ma'am Tilus. Did you get it? Guys, did you get it? Stephanie, nagets mo? I know that you are going to take the animal science only tomorrow. So, ayan. Nagets mo ba, Stephanie? Very good. So, if you get na yan, guys, so let's proceed to animal breeding and genetics. Gising pa ba si Jason? Jason. Yes, bigay ko yung recordings later. Actually, you can watch it on YouTube after. Pagising mo, pwede din po. Apo, pwede din po yun, pagising. Nakano na siya, nasave na agad siya. Okay, so let's proceed to animal genetics. Actually, there are some terminologies. Diba, nag-send ako sa GC na mga terminologies. So I want you to read on that. Okay, and then we have animal genetics. Science that studies the heredity. Heredity and variation in animals. Okay, now, who is the one who discovered DNA? The one that discovered the DNA is Friedrich. It's Friedrich, okay? The one who discovered the DNA is Friedrich, okay? Hindi po si Mendel. Hindi porket si Mendel ang father, si Mendel na yung ano, si Mendel na yung nakapag-discover ng DNA, okay? So, hindi po ibig sabihin na ganun. So, DNA, it is discovered by Friedrich. Okay? And then, who coined the alleles? Sino ang nag-coin ng alleles? Ang nag-coin po ng alleles, actually, dalawa sila. Okay? Ang nag-coin ng alleles ay si William. It's William. It's William. Yan, si William. Dalawa po yan sila. William and... Ay, nakalimutan ko yung isa. Si William. Tapos, ang nag-coin naman sa genes ay si sino yun lang? Johansen? It's Johansen? Wait.
Johansen.
Oh, it's Johansen. Very good. It's Johansen. Yes. Si Johansen is the one who coined the genes. No? Si Johansen. And also, Johansen is also known as the father of animal breeding and genetics. Am I correct, Johansen?
Jay Lashman to, sir.
Ah, sorry, si Jay Lash pala, sorry. Si Jay Lash pala yun, sorry. Jay Lash is the father of breeding and genetics. Tama? Tama ba ako? So, father of genetics, I see Gregor Mendel. Okay. And then, ang father of animal breeding, I see Robert Bakewell. It's not Robert Bakewell. J. Lush. Okay, so considered the father of modern animal breeding is Jay Lash. Si Jay Lash pala. Sorry lang, si Jay Lash, yun. Jay Lash, yun. Si Jay Lash in 1900s. He is the father of modern animal breeding. Pero meron talagang animal father ng animal breeding dati. It was Robert. Pag sa board exam, ang question is, father of modern animal breeding, that is Jay Lash. Pag ang tanong is, father of animal breeding, that is ano? That is, I mean, who discovered the breeding pala? Who discovered the breeding in animals? That is Robert Bakewell. Si Robert Bakewell ang nakadiscover ng breeding sa animals. Yan. Sino nga ba nakadiscover ng cloning? Sino ang nakadiscover ng cloning sa animal? Sino naka-discover ng cloning sa animal? Sino? Sino yung kauna-unahang clone? Na ano, anong hayop yun? It's Dali. Dali the sheep.
Dali is the first
my cloning kanina sa Grab Science si Dali. Ay, meron.
May choices na Dali.
May choices na sir po, hindi man muna sabat.
Ah, okay. Si Dali is the first cloning ship. Siya pa yung...
Ano na sir, yung ba? Si Yasa niya? Other? Other, hey, gimana?
Baka magbuwa lang balati mo. Baka magbuwa na buwas.
Other, gimana sir?
Baka magbuwa na buwas ba? Sino ka? Who discovered the cloning? Dali the cloning. Si clone Dali. Who discovered? Search natin. Kasi para ano, discover the cloning. Dali the cloning. Dali the ship. It was Ian Wilmot. Okay. Dali was cloned by Keith Campbell, Ian Wilmot, and colleagues at the Roslin Institute, part of the University of Edinburgh. Ah, okay. Siya pala. Okay. Ito pala, ah. Ilagay ko na lang to. Si Ian Wilmot. It's Ian Wilmot. Siya yung pinaka-known talaga na nakapag-successfully clone. Ay, mali.
Then, doon sa may other good man yung kwa, no?
Ha?
Sa other?
Other nga?
Yung clone? Yung yes, clone ni, ano, ni Dali.
Yeah. Yeah, correct. This one here. Yes po. Okay. So choices lang pala siya.
What's not the cloning system?
I cannot, ano? Akong tiil? It's okay. Hindi na siya, okay lang na. It's okay. Ayan. So, ayun. What else are still there, guys? Ah, modern biotechnology. Yung thank you Jorimel, modern biotechnology yung kanina na Dali. Ah, okay. I get it. Pero diniscuss ko naman 'yan sa kanya sa klase nung ano, regular class si Dali the sheep. Okay, next you have. Okay, let's proceed na para makapag-echo na tayo. Yeah, these are the application of animal genetics. Yeah, qualitative genetics tsaka ayan, quantitative. This one like, okay, this one. Ito na lang. Alleles, alternate forms of a gene. Yan na lang, take note nyo. Genes, the basic unit of heredity. Locus, location of a gene on a chromosome. Yan, screenshot nyo na. Alleles, alternate forms of the gene. Genes, the basic unit of heredity. Locus, location of a gene on a chromosome. Yan. So, this one, codominance. Codominance, two alleles are expressed in heterozygous individual. Yun. Two alleles are expressed in heterozygous individuals. Yun. Multiple alleles. Research works in genetics and animal breeding has demonstrated that in a population, there may be more than two alternative genes. So, dapat there are maybe more than two alternative genes that can occupy the locus. This is a locus. Yan. Ito. Ito yung new sa akin na term. Exon, it is the protein coding sequence. Intron, intervening sequence. I cannot explain it properly. Kasi, are you still familiar with the DNA protein? Okay, what are the DNA protein? Can you still remember the A, G, T, C? Ito, adenine.
Pairing.
Ito, guanine. Ito, thymine. Ito, cytosine. Yung four bases ba? Ng ano, four bases protein ng deoxycarbonucleic acid. DNA. Baka lalabas yun sa exam. Tapos tatanungin doon which of this is not a basis of DNA. Oh. So yun. We have adenine, guanine, thymine, and then cytosine. Yun. And
pero
then
in the, sir.
Ha?
Pair mo na sila.
Unsa?
Pair na sila.
Ah, okay.
So, okay. Iba.
Yeah. Tama. And then, we have the sequence. Dito po na-apply si exon tsaka si intron. We have exon, protein coding sequence, tapos si intron, intervening. Yan. Intervening po yan. That's intervening sequence. Intervening sequence yan. Hindi yan intervening. Intervening sequence. Ayan. So, multiple alleles. Hindi na ako makikipag-away dito. Pag AA, red.
Tignan mo.
Ayan, oh. Caps lock A, red. A, tapos small, pink. Okay. Pag small, double A, small, white. Tinatanong nila sa akin kanina, kung ang double A ba daw ay dominant or recessive. Tinatanong nila kanina sa akin. Ako sumagot. Ayan. Sorry ako talaga sumagot kasi ano, yun, nakasagot na lang ako. So ayun, ano kaya ang dalang double A?
Dominant, sir.
Ha?
Dominant?
Dominant? Ano ibig sabihin ng dominant? Kinover niya na lahat? Ganon? Ganon ba yung dominant? Uh-huh.
Superior, sir?
Superior? May choices sa superior kay Gaina? Oh. Okay. Pag AA, red, A small, A big, pink, both small A, white. And then we have black here, actually. We can have also in the dominance and recessive BB. Hi BB. Yan. BB, black. Yan, black. It's black. The phenotype is black. The genotype is BB. The phenotype is black. Tapos, BB na naman. BB, big letter yan. The genotype is BB. The phenotype is black. Ganun. And then we have both BB, yan. The genotype BB, tapos ang phenotype is red. Yan. So this is actually for a non-additive gene. That is a non-additive gene. Okay, next na tayo para makabot tayo na ano. Linkage of genes. Ito, linkage of genes, it means the presence of two non-allelic acids. A non-allelic acids, hindi magkaparehas na allelic alleles, yon. On the same chromosomes, affecting the same trait, yon. So that is linkage of genes. And we have sex link. Okay, refers to genes that are carried on the homologous portion of the X chromosomes, man, yan. On the X chromosomes, yun. Homologous portion, that is sex link. Yun. Discuss ko yan more next year. Discuss ko yan more. And then we have sex influence. Genes for sex influence traits are carried on the autosomes. Saan carried ang sex influenza autosomes? And their expression is influenced by the sex of the individual. Sex of the individual. Influenced by sex of the individuals, a male and female can have identical genotypes, but exhibit different traits. Usually, the trait is dominant in the male. That's not wrong. In the male and recessive in the female. Yeah. Dominant in the male and recessive in the female. Ayan. So that is sex influence. Okay, we have the Hardy-Weinberg law in 1908. Ito na lang, explain ko. Mutation, this one. Mutation, sudden heritable change in genetic material yan. Genetic material. So, sudden heritable change in genetic material, that is mutation. Kasi change, sudden, spontaneous, biglaan, ganun. Migration, movement of breeding animals from one population to another. That is migration. Selection, okay, artificial or natural selection, relative success in becoming a parent based on genotypes or phenotypes. Okay? Okay, now let's proceed to entomology. Did you get it? Tomorrow we'll give you more on that. Hopefully you can read all the terminologies that I sent to you sa GC. Okay? Oh, paspaso na to. Sorry. Paspaso na to, ja. Sorry. Ayan. So we have entomology. Okay. So entomology, huwag kalimutan lumabas sa exam yung other male reproductive system, that is what we call Aedicus. Okay, lumabas last year, Aedicus po yun. Other male reproductive system or other name of the penis of insect is Aedicus. Aedicus, huwag kalimutan. Makalumabas sa exam. Okay, entomologist, nasabi of insect, alam nyo na yan, matalino na kayo dyan. And then, insect, mites, tapos na tayo dyan. Okay, so this one, we have Coleoptera. Ayan. Coleoptera for beetles, dipterology flies, odonatology, dragonflies, damselflies, hemipterology, true bugs, yun, true bugs. Isopterology, termites, or social. Yan. And then, social insects. And then, we have lepidopterology, moths, and butterflies, yan. Melitology, or apiology, for the bees, yan. Then we have myrmecology for the ants. And then we have orthopterology, grasshoppers, crickets, etc. Then trichopterology, we have caddis flies, vespology, social wasps, and then apidology, aphids. Okay. By the way, wag nyo din kalimutan yung pesticides. Ano yun? Oh, classification. Yung pesticide, yung color. Ano yung category 1? What is the category 1? What color is the category 1? Red.
Red.
And it is what?
Toxic,
poisonous?
Highly toxic.
Highly toxic. Okay. Ilan yung kanyang ano niya? Less than?
1 to 50? Or less than 1 to 50?
Okay, less than 50. So, yan ay toxic na. Yeah, we have also category 2. What color?
Yellow.
Tapos, toxic.
Highly toxic
pa rin. And then, that is 52. 52? Ano? 100? Ano 50? 500? Ilan yan? Hanapin nyo. Send ko na lang sa GC yan mamaya. Ang mga color. And then we have category 3. What color category 3?
Blue?
Tulog na ata sila AJ eh.
Blue, sir.
So it is poisonous. Tama?
Moderately.
Moderately. Moderately poisonous? Toxic?
Toxic po.
And then we have category 4?
Green.
Green.
Slightly.
Ayan. So ito, mataas na to. Ang ano niya, no? Mataas na yung content niya. Okay. So yan, magkalimutan yan ha. Lalabas yan sa exam. Okay. We have, okay, history of entomology, Spanish period, we have Pegafetta's account of Palawan leaf insect, okay, the first recognizable written record of the Philippine insect in 1521. Okay. And then we have earliest recorded account of locust swarm in the Philippines in Panay Island in 1569. Okay. And then we have 1593, Spanish priest Padre Antonio was the Cedeno first planted mulberry and introduced suriculture in the Philippines, or silk. Okay. And then in 1830, opening of the port of Manila to the world commerce. Yan. Foreigners other than Spaniards were allowed to enter the country, excluding foreign explorers. Open na po for everyone. And then these are the foreign explorers, English, French, German, Russian, and Belgian explorers. And then we have the, in 1849, especially from China, Southern China, yes, ang tawag sa kanya ay Martinez, the first biological control, no, to control the locust in the Philippines. Okay? And we have the early migrant occupations. So in 1802, the Bureau of Agriculture organized control of migratory locusts, become one of its important. Okay? And then first time that a microbial agent, okay, a fungus, was used for the control of migratory locusts. Migratory locusts, microbial agent. Ang first na microbial is fungus. Ginamit. And then we have Charles S. Banks, an American, was the first government entomologist in the Philippines. Okay? And then, in 1909, Department of Entomology established with the UPCA, first headed by E.M. Ledyard. And then we have 1912, arrival of Charles F. Baker in the Philippines, and Baker became Dean of the College of Agri-UP in 1917 with the aid of Cuban collector Julian Valdez, and whom he paid of his personal funds, blah, blah, blah. Okay, ilang papers? 400. 400 papers on the Philippine insects. And then we have 1913, Mitzmain. MS found that Sura, a disease of Carabao, is treated. Sura is disease of Carabao. Mitzmain was the first to establish veterinary entomology in the country. Mitzmain ang kauna-unahang nag-establish ng veterinary entomology. And the first Filipino instructor in entomology in 1915 is Leopoldo B. Oichanko. In 1918, it's L.B. Oichanko, the first Filipino MS in entomology. Siya pa rin po. Okay? And then, rise of the Filipino entomologists, we have Oichanko, the first Filipino to obtain doctoral degree. Siya din yung sa masteral and first professor. And then, he also described the species of Cylids, first Filipino to describe Philippine insect. In 1925, first time airplane was utilized in control of migratory. In 1925, ginamit ang airplane to control migratory locust. And then, in 1934, the first report on the mites of croplands in the Philippines by Fajardo and Velosillo. Fajardo for 3. Yun. And then we have Han Santana, first Filipino trained in biological control of insects. In 1936, Oichanko theory on locust outbreaks in relation to sunspot cycle. And then 1939, report on the ecology of probable outbreak center of migratory locust by Oichanko. 1941, Viado is the first insecticide toxicologist. Viado is the first insecticide toxicologist. And then we have 1947, we have C.C.R. Baltasar, first Filipina with college degree, major in entomology. And then developments of direction in the 1670s. In 1961, we have L.C. Rimando, the first Filipino acarologist, mga, ano yan? Spiders, yun. Research on mites in the Philippines. And then 1964, B.P. Gabriel, the first Filipino insect pathologist. And then 1966, publication of the catalog of Phil Hemipteroptera by C.R. Baltasar. And then now, let's go to taxonomy, derived from the Greek word taxis means arrangement, norms means laws. Okay? Arrangement, laws, or yan, organize. Systematic, classification, nomenclature, the scientific names of animals, namings of animals, follows the rules which are outlined in the International Code of Geological Nomenclature. So either it is Latinized binomial that is composed of two words. The first one is the genus and then the species. Okay? Huwag kalimutan yan. So example, we have this one. Huwag na yan. Okay. Let's focus dito. Insects. Yun. To cut into, so it has three division. Abdomen, thorax, and head. Okay, huwag kalimutan yan. Abdomen, head, thorax, abdomen. Yun. And then it has paired segmented appendages, and they have three pairs of legs. So six legs na yun. Yan. Three pairs of legs, pairs of legs equivalent to six legs. Yun. Saan yan sila naka-attach? Sa thorax. Saan sila naka-attach? Yan. So this is exoskeleton, yung like to change ng skin, yan. And then, yan, head, thorax, and abdomen. To consider a true insect, dapat meron siyang three division, head, thorax, and abdomen. So one pair of antenna, they have one pair of antenna, and then compound eyes and ocelli. And then three pairs of legs, yan, three pairs of legs. And then they have, not all insects have wings. Okay, not all insects have wings. Okay, but they have, some of them, they have two pairs of wings. Okay, so we have head, insect head. The head is attached to the thorax, a membranous region by the neck or cervix. So these are the compound eyes, dorsal, ocelli, simple. You have here, antennae. So we have antennae, scape. Okay, we have the scape. The first, it is connected with the head. Yun, connected with the head capsule. So malapit po yan here. So this is the scape. This is the first level. And then the second level is the pedicel and followed by flagellum. Okay? First, second, and third. Baka tanongin sa exam yung second. The second antennal segment is the pedicel and flagellum is the remaining segments or the flagellomeres in individual. Okay? And then we have forms of antennae. So we have filiform, moliform, clavate, serrate, actinate, pectinate, flabellate, geniculate, plumose, and aristate. We have cetaceous, example, dragonflies and cicadas. It is bristle-like, as you can see. Segments become more slender distantly. Example, dragonfly, damselflies, and hoppers. And we have filiform, ground beetles, cockroaches. It is thread-like. Okay, thread-like. The segments, nearly uniform. Lahat po sila ay uniform, as you can see. Incisors, and usually cylindrical. Example, ground beetle, tiger beetle, yun. And then we have moniliform sa termites. Sa mga termites po yan, like string beds po siya. As you can see, string beds. Okay? And then the segments are similar in size and more or less spherical in shape. And then we have serrate. Okay, serrate is click beetle. As you can see, it's like a sawdust. Saw-like pala. Sawdust tuloy. Saw-like. Yan. It's saw-like. The segments, particularly those in distal half or thirds of the antennae, more or less triangular. But the click beetle. Yan. Pectinate. Example is sawflies and dab sandflies. Yan. Pectinate. It is comb-like. Parang suklay. Most segment with long, slender, and lateral processes. Okay. And then we have club. Okay. The segments increasing the diameter distantly. Yan. Habang tumatagal, lumalaki ang kanyang diameter. Clavate is increase in gradual. Gradual, hindi siya ganyan pag ganito. Ganyan. Palaki ng palaki, ganyan. Ganyan, ganon. And then you have capitate in the terminal segments, malaki. No, enlarge yung kanyang terminal. Sa pinakadulo, when you say terminal, sa dulo, ay malalaki. Yon, capitate po ang tawag doon. You have butterflies. Example is butterflies. Okay, and then you have lamellate, scarab beetles. Yan. If the terminal is like a segments of expanded lateral, or parang siyang wings, yan. So you can see in sa kanilang terminal, that is lamellate. Okay, and then we have geniculate. It's an elbowed. Okay, elbowed-like. With the first segment long and the following segment small and going off at an angle to the first. Okay, example, stag beetles and chalcid yun. Weevils and geniculate po yan sila. And then plumose is for mosquitoes yun. Mosquitoes, feathery, most segments with whorl or long of long hair. Example, male mosquitoes. Yan na, plumose is male mosquitoes. And then we have aristate. Aristate, the last segment usually enlarged and bearing a conspicuous dorsal bristle. Malaki. Enlarged yung kanyang last segment, yung flammigerous. Paano yun? Yun, basta. Kasunod ang pedicel, yun. And then we have stylate. Yung kanyang dulo ay manifest. Yung terminal niya is manifest. Yeah. So we have stylate. Okay, the last segment bearing elongated terminal style-like or finger-like process. Example is rubber fly. Yun. Okay, so let's proceed to the insect parts. Mandibulate or chewing. Okay. And then here we have anterior upper lip or labrum suspended form articulate. So the labrum is the upper part ha, of the lip. Sana yun ako. Saan ka na yan? Upper lip, the labrum, the lower lip is the labium. And then the maxilla is here to control, para ganun, oh, i-push-push yung pagkain. And then si mandible is here. Is this mandible? Yes, this is the mandible also. To cover, para hindi lumabas. Okay, and then we have, yan. Ito yung parang dila niya. Hypotarix. And then a pair of mandibles, yan. A pair of mandibles and segmented jaws, yan. And then we have maxillae, lower lip, basta tayo dyan, yan, mandible. Yan, we have sucking type or hostilate, also known as hostilate or sucking type, that is insect part sucking. Example, butterfly, the side here. And we have the cicada front view. So, sucking type. And we have siphoning type of mouth parts, feeds mainly on flowers, nectars, example, butterflies and moth, yan, siphoning, sinisip-sip, yan. And then we have sponging type of mouth parts. Example is, yan, moscoid flies and house flies, sponging. And then we have chewing or lapping. Example, bees, chewing tapos lapping, okay? Then we have rasping or sucking. Example, eye trips, okay? Rasping tapos sucking. Nire-raps muna tapos sucking. Pursing mouth part. Example po nito ay mosquito. Pursing mouth part. Okay, and then we have, yeah, the position of the mouth parts, we have prognathus, hypognathus, and opisthognathus. Pag hypo, the mouth parts hang ventrally from the head capsule. Hypo. Parang ano din siya, parang hypogel, pababa. Hang, naghang lang siya, pababa yung kanyang mouth part. And then, prognathus, characterized by the anterior directly position of the mouth parts. Prognathus, directly towards the mouth parts. And then, opisthognathus, mouth parts are directed ventro-posteriorly relative to the head capsule. Pag ganito, yan. Example, hemiptera or homoptera, opisthognathus. Parang ano, elephant. Yun. And then, now let's go to thorax. Yan. The middle, the thorax region, which is the locomotor tagma. So, always remember that the thorax is the locomotor. Okay? So, there are three top division of thorax. Part pro, mesa, and meta. The first wing located in the mesa. The second wing is located in the meta. The first leg is located in the pro. The second is mesa. And the mesa leg, meta leg, ang third. Okay? So, yun. Ang tawag naman sa dalawa is, anong tawag dun sa dalawa? Pagkasama ang mesa and meta. Ayan, totorax. Ayan, totorax pala. Totorax, yan. Pterothorax, pagkasama ang mesothorax and metathorax. Ang tawag ay pterothorax. Yan. Now, let's go to insect legs. Most insects have three pairs of leg, walking legs. Yan. Okay, we have coxa, the basal segment po, which is attached with the shoulder. And trochanter is the small segments here. This is the trochanter. The coxa is here. The femur is here. Magtanungin kayo, what is the male reproductive system of the insect? Hindi po yun femur. Hindi po nag-fingers ang insect. Okay. It's the first long segment of the legs and that is femur. Okay. The basal segment is the coxa. Ha? Ang pinakauna-una is the coxa. And then, tibia is the second long segmented. First segmented long femur. Second is tibia. And then, pretarsus consists of single claw. Yan. So, what are the insect legs? We have apodus. Apodus is lacking legs. Example, maggots and female scale insects. Okay, those are apodus. And we have ambulatory or walking legs. Adapted for walking. Yun. Ambulatory or walking. Yun. Adapted for walking. Coursural, adapted for running. Example, cockroach. Coursural. Fossorial, term commonly used to denote the adaption for digging. Like mole crickets. Yun. Fossorial tawag doon. Raptorial for praying mantis. Grabbing and holding prey. Yun. Grabbing and holding prey, that is raptorial. Okay? For example, praying mantis. Saltatorial, example, grasshoppers, adapted for jumping. Enlargement of the femur for jumping. And then natatorial legs is for swimming. Example, mga diving beetles, yun. Okay? So those are the types of insect legs. And then we have insect wings. Okay? So we have modification. Elytra, hard, matigas yung labas niya, pero sa loob, andun yung mga membranous hindwings. Example po ng order niya, Coleoptera at Dermaptera. Those are beetles, yun. And then we have Hemelytra. Hemelytra, front wings that are leathery, yun. Ang forewings nila are leathery. As you can see a triangle here. Pag nakita nyo ang triangle, it means sign of a true bugs. Okay, it is a sign of true bugs. To consider that is a true bugs, there should be a triangle sign at the back of the insects. Okay? Example, we have Heteroptera of the Hemelytra. Leathery po ang kanyang wings. And then we have Tegmina, okay? Front wings that are completely leathery. Lahat po ay leathery. Leathery ang front wings niya. Example, Blattodea, Orthoptera, and Mantodea. And then we have halteres. This one here, the halteres for flight purposes. Yeah, for flight purposes. Small club-like hand wings that serve as microscopic stabilizers during flight. We have diptera. Example, diptera. Haltery for flight purposes. We have fringe wings. Yan. Slender front wings with long fringe. Example, Tysonoptera. Mga trips. Okay? And then we have hairy wings. Yan, maraming ganito. Okay, Trichoptera. Yan, Trichoptera, front and hind wings, cloth and with setae. And then we have scaly wings for butterfly. Yon, Lepidoptera. Okay? And then hamuli is a tiny hook used for holding from yan, hamuli. Yan. Tiny hooks, may tiny hooks in the wings that hold front and hind wings together, which is Hymenoptera. Example is Hymenoptera. And we have frenulum. Yan, si frenulum ay nakikita yan sa mga paniki. Merong frenulum sa mga paniki. Yan. Bristlenere, base of hind wings that holds front and hind wings together. So example, we have Lepidoptera. And we have, okay, so that all for ano. Actually, itong, sana yun, hamuli can be used for pollen. Pollen ba yun? To hold pollen? Sa pollination, yun. And then now, let's proceed to abdomen. Okay, abdomen. So these are the parts. We have tympanum, sternite, spiracles. This is the, ano, where the respiratory system of saan nagbe-breathe yung insect po sa spiracle yun. yung respiration na nangyayari. Sa spiracle po yun. Okay? And yan, spiracle, yung mga butas-butas, that's considered as nose, parang saan yung respiratory ano nila system, yun. Okay? Then you have the sternum and you have the obispatorium. Sa lalaki, edigos po tawag. Edigos. Okay? Sting, yun. Sting naman is for bees. Yan. Yeah, sting. Okay, for bees. Ovipositor found only in the female. Kaya ang bees po ay hindi nangangagat. Nagsisting lang po sila. Okay, so what are the metamorphosis? Ito, pinaka-importante sa lahat. Metamorphosis, hopefully gising pa kayo. This is the process of changes in size, shape, and form in the insects. Example, we have love stages. What are the three stages? Egg, young, immature, young or immature intervening stage called pupa, and adult or imago. So let's start first with the, so this is what we call the complete metamorphosis. Okay? Yan po ang complete metamorphosis, pero check natin mamaya. Okay, we have emetabulus. Emetabulus, no metamorphosis. Wala siyang metamorphosis, incomplete siya. So no change in the appearance of the young. Walang changes. Kung ano siya bata, ganun din paglaki. So orders, Columbella, Protora, Diptera, and Tesanola. So this is emetabulus. Egg from the egg, tapos kung ano ang pagkabata, ang paglaki niya, ganun pa rin. Okay? So that is emetabulus. Parum metabolus, gradual metamorphosis changes in the form or our simple stages are egg or nymph. Ang tawag sa young stages or immature stages niya ay nymph. Okay? Egg, nymph, tapos adult. Okay? So example ay orders Hemiptera, Homoptera, Orthoptera, Tesanoptera, Malupaga, Anoplora, Physocoptera, Dermoptera, Isoptera, yan. This is what we call parametabolous development of grasshopper. From egg, young, nymph or young one, and then nymph, another nymph or young two, and then adult. Okay? So my nymph, that is parametabolous. Hemimetabula is an incomplete metamorphosis. The stages are egg, and then ang young ay tinatawag na naiyad. Kung kanina, nymph, dito naman, naiyad. Example, naiyad are aquatics. Okay, they are aquatics. So example, Odonata, Ephemeroptera, Plecoptera, yun. So this is example of hemetabulous metamorphosis in dragonfly. Egg, tapos naiyad, young, immature. Naiyad emerges from water, nag-emerge siya from water, immature pa rin na yang, and then adult. Okay? So that is hemimetabolus. Incomplete, and ang yang ay tawag na iyad. Si Pauro, nymph ang tawag sa yang. Si holometabolus naman ay complete metamorphosis which has egg, larva, pupa, and adult. Okay, example po niyan, Neuroptera, Coleoptera, Streptocera, Plecoptera, Trichoptera, Lepidoptera, Diptera, Cepidoptera, Hymenoptera. Yun. So we have from egg, okay, from egg going to larva, then larva, three stages of larva, then pupa, and then adult. Okay, ano nga ba ang complete holometabolus? Hememe ay naiyad, pauru is nymph, and amitabulus, no metamorphosis. Yun. Okay? Did you get it? Mabilis ka masyado, sir. Nag-gets ba ninyo? Tama nga yun. Yung category 1, extremely. It's red and extremely toxic. Category 2, yellow. It's highly toxic. Category 3, blue, it's moderate, and category 4 is green, or slightly. Yun. Nag-gets ninyo? Nag-gets ninyo yan? Lalabas yun sa exam. Okay, and then now, let's go to the pests of major agricultural crops. Let's start first with the mollusk pest, the giant African snail. Okay, we have the gastropoda, bite, base of seedling, and leaves. Okay. We have the golden apple snail, ang dakilang kaaway ng rice. ng lowland rice, golden apple snail or Pomaceae canaliculata. Okay, it is cut base of seedling and leaves. Ang ginagawa niya ay cut niya ang base tapos seedling and the leaves. Okay? And we have also santol gall mites. Okay, santol gall mites is ang Acarina. Yan. Sa Eriopais sandorisi. Yon. Galls form on leaves. Saan na po form ang galls? Sa leaves ng santol. And yellow mite, Polypagotarsonimus latus or banks ang tawag, yellow mite. Okay, Tarsonidae carina attacks buds and younger leaves. Na-attack niya ang buds at younger leaves resulting in formation of long shoots with chlorotic, narrow, and curled leaves. Cassava mite naman, Tetranychus canzawai, mite pest rin po yan. Okay, so ang atake niya ay sa leaves initially show yellow blotches. May yellow blotches which coalesce and leaf tissue becomes entirely yellow. Okay. And then we have rice insect pests. Oh, ito, huwag kalimutan ha. Green leaf hoppers, Nepotetics varicens po yan. Okay, ang atake ni Nepotetics varicens po ay sa saan? Sa upper leaves, wilted. Upper leaves wilted, young plants stop growing and die. Namamatay, nag-stop na mag-grow ang mga young plants and then namamatay. And then panicle formation often seriously impaired. And then always remember that green leaf hopper or Nepotetics varicens is the reason also that transmit the tongro virus of the rice. Itong pinahighlight natin na part, tongro virus of the rice, Nepotetics varicens. And we have the plant, a brown plant hopper or known as Delphacidae hemiptera. Brown plant hopper, Neleparvata lugens po yan. Tawag yan. Neleparvata lugens. And then, ang kanyang atake is plants wilted and dwarfed. Wilted and dwarfed. Heavy sooty. Mold growth on surfaces of leaves. Then, exhibits characteristics hopper burn due to direct feeding. Then, transmit the grassy stunt. Yun. And Raj stunt virus. Yun. And then we have, oh, this one, you need to memorize this, ha, stemper. Kasi lumalabas sa exam dito, alin daw sa sumusunod ang pink or yellow? May ganung tanong sa board exam. Pag striped stem borer po, ang scientific name niya is Chilo soprisalis. Chilo soprisalis. It is Lepidoptera. Okay? Pag yellow stem borer, ang scientific name niya is Serpopaga insertulas. Serpopaga insertulas. Or example is Lepidoptera. We have pink stem borer, Sesamia inferens. Sesamia inferens. Okay? Ang it is in Lepidoptera. White stem borers, Carpopaga enotata. Yan, white. So we have Pyralidae or Lepidoptera. Noong time namin, ang lumabas is pink. Tinanong kung ano ang scientific name ng pink stem borers. That is Sesamia inferens. Yun. And then, always remember, pag sa younger leaves and growing points, whether exhibiting the so-called dead heart. Yan po nangyayari ang dead heart. During what stage? Vegetative stage. Nagkakaroon ng symptoms during vegetative stage. Sa younger leaves, dead heart. Huwag kalimutan, lumalabas yan sa exam. Okay? Plants attack the reproductive stage exhibit while empty panicles known as whitehead. Pag nagkaroon ng empty ang panicles, okay, during reproductive stage, that is whitehead. Dito, vegetative stage, nagkakaroon ng symptoms in the younger leaves, ang tawag dead heart. Dito, during reproductive stage, nawawalan na ng laman ang panicles, that is whitehead. This one is an example of whitehead. Okay? Next, we have rice bug. Okay, scientific name of rice bug, Leptocoryza oratorius, or it is under order Hemiptera. Okay? It is a true bug. So you can see here. Grain stained brown, panicles empty or underdeveloped. Ang ginagawa niya, sinisip-sip niya yung tinatawag natin na milk. Milking. Yeah, milking stage. Sorry, that's the milking stage of the rice. Yun, sinasak niya. Sinisip-sip niya yan sa panicles hanggang mawala. Okay, and then we have corn or corn borer. Corn borer is also known as Ostrinia fornicalis, or it is under Lepidoptera. The larva bores holes on stem, leaves, and ears. Lumabas sa exam kung ano daw ang part ng corn ay female. Ano daw? Okay. We have corn semiluper. So, corn semiluper is Cresodexis eriosoma or Lepidoptera. And then, young plants, inatake niya sa young plants, leaf blade eaten, living only veins, and midrid. And then, we have corn seedling maggot. Yee, this is maggot. I don't like it. Yeah, it's like, it's diptera, affected in the young plants with younger leaves drying. That is dead hard. Dead hard. Okay, dead hard pag younger leaves. Okay, corn earworm. Corn earworm. Corn earworm or Helicoverpa armigera is a Lepidoptera. The larva bores on young unfolded leaves, ears heavily attack. Yung atake niya ng larva na yan ay sa ears. Okay, sa mga young. And then we have white grub. Okay, hindi naman lalabas si white grub. Eto, 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 huwag kalimutan. Stored grains, rice weevil, a scientific name is Cetophilus oryzae. It is under the order of Coleoptera. Under the order of Coleoptera. Corn weevil, Cetophilus diamaced. Yan. Rice moss, Corsaira cephalonica, Lepidoptera. And then feed on both milled and unmilled grains. Direct grain damage. Okay, so this one in the sugar cane, they are the root grub. Okay, so we have Leucophilus erorata or Coleoptera. Yun. And then you have in the sugar cane also the dead heart borer, Tetramoira cistacenia, Lepidoptera. Dead heart pa rin, causing dead heart sa larva stem. Sayang. Okay, so you have sugar cane, yellow top borer, Chilo infuscatilus, Lepidoptera, larva bores through stems, loss of sugar content. Pag mawala ang sugar content because of yellow top borer, Chilo infuscatilus. Yan. So we have crucifers, diamondback moth, lumalabas na ito sa exam. Si diamondback moth, Protella silostella, that is Lepidoptera. Leaves eaten, kinakain niya yung, as you can see here, kinakain niya yung leaves, turn into lace-like appearance with irregular small holes on leaves. And then we have cabbage worm, yan, Crocidolomia pavonana, yan, Lepidoptera, irregular perforation on leaves. And then we have cutworm, Spodoptera letura, or Lepidoptera, yan, irregular portion of leaves eaten out, yon. And then we have cucurbits, yellow squash beetle, Aula corpora indica. Okay, and then we have, ito, ito, melon fruit fly, Dacus cucurbita. Okay, it's a diptera. Fruit rotting inside with maggots. No, it has a maggots. Yeah, tomato lady beetle, or known as Epilachna vigentio octopunctata. Yes, octopunctata. Filipinensis, yan, Coleoptera. Atake niya adults and larva scrape epidermis of leaves, resulting in characteristics net-like damage. Eggplant shoot borer, yan. Leucinodes orbinalis, Lepidoptera po yan under. Growing shoots and fruits are bored shoots, are bored and shoots eventually die. Hanggang mamatay ito. And then cotton strainer, yan. Hindi ko na alam kung lalabas yan. Kingua latus yan. Cotton bollworm, Helicoverpa armigera, Lepidoptera yan, bores through floral bud and developing balls. Yan. Sweet potato weevil, Silas formicarius, Coleoptera yan siya, tuber and rotting section, and then many, open many tunnels containing white, slightly curved. My bitter taste. And then mango leafhopper, Idioscopus, yan. You have blossom wither and fruit setting prevented and sooty molds abundant. Okay, and then we have fruit fly. Okay, fruit fly or Philippine fruit fly, Bactrocera filipinensis. Yan. Fruit fly, wag kalimutan, Bactrocera filipinensis. Okay, maggots feed on fruits which eventually rot due to secondary contamination with pathogens. Mango, twig borer, Teponoclea albata or under order Coleoptera. Yan. Banana leaf roller, Erionata thrax or Lepidoptera. Portion of leaves rolled powdery caterpillar inside feeds on the leaves. And then we have banana weevil, Cosmopolites, Sordidus, Coleoptera. Then plants will turn yellow and collapse because of banana weevil. Yeah, so the stem infested with weevil groups. And then we have abaca aphids, this one. Pentalonia nephornervosa. Okay? Nephornervosa. Hemiptera and transmit virus causing bunchy tap system. Ooh, pag lumabas sa exam, what insect the transmitting virus causing bunchy tap symptom of abaca, and that is abaca aphids or Pentalonia nephornervosa. Yun. And then Asiatic palm weevil. Yan. Coconut, rhinoceros, beetle. Uso ngayon is kadang-kadang disease. Viroids. Kadang-kadang disease, viroids. Ano pa? Cocolisap. That can be prevented through biological control. Biological control. And this is the insect in the coffee. Coffee berry borer. Aside coffee rust, meron din coffee berry borer. Hypotenus hampei. It is under order Coleoptera. Okay, and then we have left folder. Cacao, this one. Cacao or Pachyrhinchus moniliferus. Rurusa. Adults feed on bark. Ang adults na feed niya sa bark. Leaves and bore through fruits. Larva also feed on fruits. Kaya pagbukas mo sa ano niya, sa pads, merong larva minsan. Cacao, mealybug, yan. Pink mealybug, ang pink mealybug, Planococcus, Coccus, Lela, Sinus, yan. Meptera, and then flappy, pinkish mealy, bugs, and then sooty mold present. And then, cacao pod borer, Morpa, Crimeralei, Lepidoptera, and then yan, beanfly, aphids, ano ba? Yan, migratory locus, yan. Locus na doon. Oriental, migratory locus, locusta, migratoria manilensis. Yun. Leaves defoliated. Leaves defoliated. Yun, so, ayan. So, ayun dyan ba kayo? Ayan, saan dyan pa pala sila? Sorry. Ayan! So, alam nyo na ibig sabihin niya na, mga physical, mechanical control, cultural control, yun. Pag may narinig po kayo, like mga traditional na method, that is under cultural control. Physical and mechanical control, pwede po yung isahan na lang. Yun. Pero biological control, bio, predators, ng isang insect to eat or be a pest to other insect, chemical, ways of synthetic, then yung mga legal control din. Okay? So, ayan. So, you still have time. You can sleep na po. Thank you very much for watching and for being with me until the end of our presentation. Hopefully, nasunod niyo po yun. Sana nga. And tomorrow morning, you can access the video on YouTube. Just go in the live section. Tapos makita niyo doon yung recorded nito. It's directly recorded. Okay? So, thank you very much everyone for listening until the end of our class. And then tomorrow, good luck po. God bless and again, advance chukka hamnida. Again, kamsahamnida everyone. Anyong hejo mo soyo. Bye-bye. Chara soyo. Kamsahamnida. Bye-bye. Chukka hamnida. Bye-bye everyone. Good night. Bye-bye. On YouTube also, thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye po. Good night. Thank you very much. There are 23 viewers on YouTube. Thank you very much for watching those on YouTube. Thank you. Kamsahamnida. Annyeonghae jamaseyo. Jajayo. Jarasayo. Advance chukhamnida. Bye bye everyone. Yung iba natulog na.